All right, so ladies and gentlemen, moving on to the next speaker, we are inviting the coordinator for Research Facilities and Services Marine Research Center, Mr. Triyono, SSI MTDS Master of Science, and he will be presenting Unveil the Deep Sea Mystery in the Eastern Waters of Indonesia. And to introduce you a bit about Mr. Triyono, he has been completing his master degree in Diponegoro University and becoming an alumni of Université de Brest-France, and he's currently serving as the head of adaptation and conservation mitigation research, or PUSRIKEL, Human Resources Research Agency in KKP. He is also a member of research team of Indonesia and USA Collaborative Expedition or INDEX SATAL in 2010 in Sangihe Talaut. So without any further ado, we would like to welcome Mr. Triyono, SSI MTDS Master of Science, and let's give a big round of applause to welcome Mr. Triyono.
Thank you so much, Ibu Moderator and Pak Januar. First of all, the Honorable Chief of Staff of the Indonesian Navy, Bapak Admiral Yudo Margono, the Honorable Commander of PUS Hidrosal, Bapak Vice Admiral Dr. Agung Prastiawan, MEP, and the distinguished guests and participants, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, depending on the words you are tuning in. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. It's a great honor for me to stand here and have this opportunity for the presentation. First of all, I would like to congratulate Bapak Komandan PUS Hidrosal for the successful completion of Jala Citra Aurora Expedition 2021. Today I like to share the experience of INDEX SATAL exploration and in relation with the Jala Citra preliminary survey results. I will commence from the background of INDEX SATAL exploration. Next. And then I will follow with the presentation about the Jala Citra Aurora preliminary result in comparative study with INDEX SATAL result. The United States and Indonesia team up to explore Sangir Talaut water in Sulawesi Sea, starting from the scientific question about the mystery of hidden volcano below the ocean. Ocean exploration is an interdisciplinary approach for assessing and investigating the physical, chemical, and biological characteristics of the ocean floor, the ocean itself, and the diversity of life form that inhabit in the marine environment. Ocean exploration is intended to yield a body of knowledge that may result in immediate benefit. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Ocean exploration is intended to yield a body knowledge that may result in immediate benefits or may inform research hypotheses that result in new scientific understanding in the future. Primary science objective for the joint Indonesia-US exploration expedition are to first locate sites of the interest for exploration, especially for the deep sea hydrothermal vent, coral reef, ship sites, and fish habitat. And second, conduct geological, geophysical, biogeographical, and biodiversity assessment of these sites. And third, identify potential connection between the sites. And four, initiate broad characterization of the ecosystem relationship in the region explored. Next, once again. The uniqueness of seafloor geology was the reason that this exploration is matter. The Ring of Fire made up a specific volcano arch from Mindanao Island to Talaud. Next. Scientists convinced that every continent is characterized by its fauna. At least there are group of fauna in the world, depending on the continent. So, to be expected that underwater also provide a large varied habitat and biodiversity, as Pak Kadarusman said before. For many scientific data convincing us that there is no doubt if Indonesia is the center of mega biodiversity of the planet, especially expressed by coral triangle. Next, please. Marine biodiversity is our future, Indonesia food security and economy. The exploration of this potential high diversity is in the deep coral triangle was one of the main motivation from the biological point of view for the Index Atal expedition. Next, please. Okay, next. Yeah. The exploration was conducted on the Indonesia research vessel Barunajaya 4 and the US NOAA ship Oceanos Explorer. Multibeam sonar was used by the two research vessels to map of what on the seafloor. We also used ROV to be sent down to investigate the underwater volcano by collecting of high definition video still images of the deep water. ROV and CTD also used to characterize the oceanographic aspect of water column. Next, the telepresence is a high technology to transfer the data from the ship direct to the satellite and then transfer again to the ICC or Exploration Command Center in Jakarta and in Seattle. Next. More than 25 deep sea habitats were discovered and explored between 250 and 3,600 meter depth in the virtually unexplored Sulawesi Sea of Indonesia. Multibeam also revealed the detail of Sangir Talaud area and map submarine volcano Kavio Barat, which is rises approximately 5,400 meter from seafloor and its peak is about 1890 below sea surface. Next, please. This is the Simon, as Ibu Andini said. Simon, the name of the Simon is Kavio Barat in Sulawesi Utara or North Sulawesi. And about the hydrothermal activity, and the next slide. We should know that the hot spring on the ocean floor is releasing warm and mineral-rich fluids called hydrothermal vent. Next, please. Hydrothermal vents should found in exploration associated with Kavio Barat submarine volcano. Next. From CTD cast that we conducted so that there were no temperature anomalies in the hydrothermal area, but the LSS and RRP results indicate a strong concentration reduced species S, H2S and FA. And from the ROVSEN, next slide, please. The imagery collected during the expedition revealed a diversity of benthic habitat harboring distinctly different ecosystem, including thriving semosynthetic and non-semosynthetic communities. The dominant fauna in the hydrothermal vent system from the active volcano Kawio Barat were stream that cover the sites of active smoker and stock barnacle that carpeted inactive chimney and area of diffuse flow. Other fauna were alvinellids or paleseta worm, scale worm, galatid, and barisiuran crab. Beautiful animal also find in this expedition. Please, next slide. Beautiful animal that were found, including brittle star, tripod fish. This is a beautiful fish. Next slide, please. A beautiful fish because that fish can stand on its fin. And sea cucumber, a glass pond, giant glowing starfish, and any others. Next. Okay. From the expedition, we also find the deep sea fishes. It was about 53 of 32 fish family, and 10 shrimp family of 19 species, and 5 family of cephalopod of 7 species were discovered and identified by Baruna Jaya 4, the Indonesian research vessel. Next. After completing Indeks Satal exploration, Indonesia-US deep sea exploration aims to conduct Indeks Halmahera 2011 with a focus on benthic habitat, midwater oceanography, biodiversity, seafloor geological aspect, and other, but it was canceled by some reason. So please let me jump to the next slide, please. Okay, the Jala Citra Aurora Expedition. This slide was a result of a discussion with Pak Oke, the chief of Jala Citra Exploration. Thank you for the discussion, Pak Oke. Next, please. Jala Citra Aurora was conducted to unveil mystery of Halmahera Sea regarding the unsurfaced areas in 1928 and the uniqueness of seafloor geology, which is expressed by double subduction, area, and suppose that underwater volcano exists, seawater mass mixing as a phenomena of oceanographic aspect, and last marine biodiversity. Jala Citra was conducted in 4 etapes with many equipment and instruments such as SBP, magnetometer, gradiometer, gravity core, CTD, ADCP, and others. From the marine geological aspect, please, next. Double volcanic activity, in example, Sangir to North Sulawesi Arch and West Halmahera Volcanic Arch are indicated. Mapping were used MBS EM302 to determine seafloor morphology. Simon Peak was found at 393 meter depth. Meanwhile, the slope is spreading to more than 1,000 meter deep. The fact is found that is that if Kawio Barat in Sulawesi Utara or in Sulawesi Sea is surrounded by a continuous volcanic arch, meanwhile, the Simon in Aura Survey is likely stand alone. Next. Based on the Index Satal result, the temperature is poor indicator for determining hydrothermal. It was about 0.5 degrees Celsius near hydrothermal vent. Otherwise, the anomaly could be found in conductivity measurement. Jala Citra found anomalies at the 500 to 600 meter depth close to the Simon. Suppose that mixing were weakly existed. Next. Marine ecosystems are regionally classified by their coral diversity and defined as ecoregion. Grab sampling conducted by Jala Citra on top of Simon found some coral which have different type and ones at the Sangir Talaut water. Is that reliable indicator for the mixing, for the existing of mixing fauna eastern and western part of Indonesia? We do still believe that there will advance study to define by Pak Angga Dwino Pantio from Lipi Brin, we hope. And the last is about the fisheries aspect. Next, please. From the fisheries aspect, first, distribution pattern of the fishes are affected by several oceanographic parameters such as SST, chlorophyll A, salinity, and others. Each type of fish has different optimal level of particular oceanographic parameter. For example, skipjack tuna or chakalang is more likely schooling at 0.2 milligram per meter cubic of chlorophyll A. Albacore tuna, according to the FAO 2011, has suitable habitat at 23 to 38 PSO. In the aspect of fisheries, the expedition conducted at fisheries management area of 717, as Pak Kadarusman said before, where the potential fisheries is pelagic fish. The expedition recorded salinity at 33 PSO at 10 meter depth that might indicate an area of tuna schooling. However, we should need extend data to characterize the chlorophyll A and the DO. Next, we are talking about the future of seabed material. Deep sea is the remotest parts of the planet that also attracted massive interest from global industry as a potential source of metal and particularly rare earth element used in many electronic devices. Shifting tectonic plates in the deep sea create fissure in the earth's crust and allow hot magma to creep to seep close to the seabed. In some conditions, seawater percolates through the crust, become a superheated mineral-rich flood that back to the ocean. This process makes a complex set of chemical reaction leads a mineral out of the rock, but when the hot water meet the cold water, the mineral will spirit. What mineral can be found in this separation is gold, copper, zinc, manganese, and more. The metal that are contained copper and lithium are used in things like batteries. But the problem is how to mine this without destroying the vein, because destroying the vein means destroying its ecosystem. Deep sea ecosystem is also important for the human health, because bacteria that living in the spawn produce antibacterial compound to make antibiotic and other pharmacological uses. Other bacteria is also useful for industrial, like oil, gas, and detergent, paper, and also drink. Next, please. This is the use of some microbe in the deep sea. And I think this is my end of presentation. Thank you for the attention. And Jala Citra Praya Yuda Jala Siva Jaya Mahi. Thank you very much.
What an amazing presentation. And yes, I have to be very honest. To be honest with you, Dr. Yanur, it is my first time to see the pictures of the deep sea habitat. And it's very interesting.
The diversity of marine diversity is very rich.
Yeah.
Especially for Indonesia.
Yes. And to highlight once again what Mr. Triyono just told us about the three expeditions that were conducted in Halmahera waters, such as Index Satal, Index Halmahera, and of course Aurora expedition. And the two key points need to be highlighted and to be noted that between those expeditions, we can see that by comparing the marine geology results between expeditions and the physical oceanographic result, they are closely matched. You probably want to add up some more points, Dr. Yanwar?
Even though the result is closely matched, yeah. There's must one most important thing that within the two expeditions, the other one in fighting other countries or involving foreign countries in doing the research for the Jalachitra Aurora, we are completely national scientists and national asset.
Wow, involved. We do it in our own. Let's give another big round of applause. That's also another thing to be very proud of.
Yeah, very big achievement for all of us, of course.
For all of us.